Hey, what's up? Oh, let me make sure my phone is on silent. Hey, what's up? It's HJ, and welcome to my channel. I am going to talk to you guys today about 5 red flags. Like, if you see these, you're going to want to contemplate the situation. 5 red flags in relationships. They might be things that are going on with somebody that you like, you have a crush on, you're dating, you're courting, whatever you want to call it. And you just might not notice them. So I'm here and I want to bring 5 things that are common to your attention that could be red flags. Number 1, we're just going to get the big one out of the way, okay? If homeboy or homegirl is constantly and consistently making every conversation impure and about sex or sexual, like, that is a major red flag. Because it's one thing, like, yeah, we have impure thoughts, right? It happens, let's keep it real, impure thoughts. But to go so far as to make the thought come out of your mouth and shifting conversations to make it about sexual things or make it about impure things on a consistent basis, you don't need that. That's just not wise for you who are trying to be pure, right? And trying to repent of impure thoughts and asking the Lord to help create in you a pure heart and all of these things. And if that person keeps talking about and laughing about and making everything impure again, it's gonna be hard for you in your walk when you're trying to do the right thing and you're trying not to think like that and talk like that right now while you're not married. And it's hard out here when you're single. They're making it hard for you. 1, they got some stuff going on in their heart. 2, and then 3, that's just immature to think that you can be a Christian and love the Lord and continuously cause your brother or sister to stumble and continuously make everything impure. Like, if they really think that's okay, then that's just like an right there. So yeah, if they're constantly making everything dirty, they gotta go to the trash. Number 2, do they read their Bible on their own? So this might be something that you may not have noticed because you see them at Bible study, you see them at church, they have a group that they go to, and you see them reading their Bible a couple times a week, so you're like, oh yeah, they're good. No, I'm not saying do they read their Bible. I'm saying do they read their Bible on their own? Not whenever they have to on a Sunday morning or a Sunday night. Not when they have to at Bible study or home group. When they wake up in the morning or when they go to sleep at night or any time in between, when nobody's watching, do they desire to cultivate a relationship with their God that is personal and that is not contingent upon outside forces? That is so key and so important. The last thing you want is to end up with somebody that has no personal relationship with the Lord because they never read God's word. They don't know what it says. They're not gathering wisdom. They're not maturing as a believer. That's literally how important reading God's word is. Actually, I'm gonna link 8 reasons to read your Bible daily below. Read that. I'm gonna link it right here somewhere. It's gonna go across the screen. Right click it and do open in a new tab and watch it in a minute because that's an important one. Not reading your Bible causes so many branches of different sins that it's deep. So yeah, that's a whole thing on its own. But if they do not read their Bible on their own, they gotta go. Number 3. Tres. What was number 3? Oh yes. Now, if you're like 15 years old and you're watching this, maybe this doesn't apply right now in this moment, but keep it in mind because if you're like 18 years old, 19 years old, especially if you're older than that, if your person that you're crushing on, you like, you're dating, you're courting, whatever, has no goals for their life, I'm not just talking about dreams. Like, one day I really want to, dreams are great, but I mean like goals. Okay, what are you doing to get there? How are you going to accomplish this? And here's the thing, it doesn't even have to be, I'm not talking about Disney, when you wish upon a star. I'm not saying they have to be, I want to be an astronaut and I want to be the ruler of XYZ element of P. I'm just saying in general, do they have goals and are they doing anything to meet them? The last thing you want is a lazy person laying around in your life, not adding any value to his or her own life or your life. And that does matter, especially if you're a girl and you're seeking a boy and he one day as a husband will be the provider for his family. If he's not proving that he's gonna be a good provider, then Like, it's godly to have goals. Number four.
I should've wrote these down. Don't know what I was gonna say.
Okay, do they have friends? And this seems, again, so simple, but it's something that you might not have realized is very important and is a red flag. But are they only with you 24/7 and they don't have any friends of their own? They don't have other relationships. They don't, if they're a dude, they don't have godly men in their life. If they're a girl, they don't have godly women in their life. If they don't have friends and you guys are just like stuck to each other like glue 24/7, sucking the life out of each other, like, it's not good. Because one of the key ways that God set it up, like it's his perfect design for us to grow and mature as believers, is to be around other believers consistently, like be the church, not be yourself, not just be boyfriend and girlfriend, not just be lovers, not just be two people that like each other, but like be the church and be around other believers so you can grow and you can help other people grow, and that perfect pattern like works together so that everybody in the local community can look more like Christ and meet each other's needs and serve each other and pray for each other and love each other. But if your person doesn't have anyone in their life, and maybe not just even one person, like, because it's easy to have a best friend, but just like multiple people that they care about and they're serving and they're loving, that's a red flag. Okay, number five, ladies, this is important. And I know you heard it before, so I'm gonna say it again. And, okay, how does he treat his mother? Is he kind? Does he serve her whenever she's nagging on him or annoying him or telling him what to do or giving him godly wisdom? Is he like, okay, yeah, I know, I'll get to it, whatever. Serve himself, not serve her. She needs something, do it yourself. It's right there, you're right. Like this type of attitude where he doesn't love her, he doesn't serve her, he doesn't treat her well, he doesn't honor her, then you cannot expect him to love you like, then you cannot expect him to love you and honor you and serve you well if he's 19, 20, 30, 40 years old and he hasn't done that ever in his life. It's not like all of a sudden you get married and it's just like, I'm gonna be the most loving, honoring, serving person to the woman in my life, even though I've never been this way towards my mother ever in my life. It doesn't work like that. So yeah, if he just doesn't respect his mama, he's gotta go. He needs a spanking. And that's one thing I love about Roman. Like, he loves his mom, he loves his family. His family's so dope. I love them. You guys are great if you're watching this. So yeah, that's five things. And let me just encourage you with this. Just because one of those things may be true in the person you like's life, I'm not telling you to just say, I dump you right now, we're done, this will never work, we will never be married. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying these are red flags that you need to pray about, seek wisdom about, and be discerning on whether or not it is something that's intense enough to leave that person, or maybe they're just unaware. Like, there's so many blind spots in my life that I'm unaware of sin, and Roman will come alongside me and be like, wow, you really sin in this area. You need to work on that. You need to pray about it. Let's pray about it. Let's read scripture about it. And then I'm just like, dang, and I'm repentive of it and I want to work on it. And so if you bring it to their attention and they repent of it, they really feel the weight of their sin. They see what this kind of sin can cause in your relationship, and they want to be different, then that's great. Like, that's part of a relationship too, working things out together in a godly manner. But if you bring it to them and they don't want to repent of it and they don't care and they don't see that it's even like bad, then that might be a time for you to get with your mentor and be like, look, I really do like this person, but I don't know. So I just wanted to encourage you because I want to see you guys in healthy relationships. I want to see you guys searching for the right people, not wasting your time with goofies, pretty much. Don't waste your time with goofies. So yeah, I love you guys. Like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I put out content every week. Please share this video, share it with somebody who you think might need to hear it, share it on your Facebook, share it on your Twitter, share it anywhere and everywhere because the way that we're going to grow and reach more people with the truth of God's word is through people discovering that these videos even exist. So share, like, subscribe. I love you guys so much. Bye.